The road is long, with a many a winding tongue that leads us to who knows where.
He was 3 years older, and I was in the middle, and then Andy was 3 years younger. And when my dad bought that house, I was like 9 years old, and we moved out of two rooms by itself. And the first thing Andy asked me, he said, do we have a bathroom? Because we used to have just an outside toilet, you know? I said, yeah, we have a bathroom at the new house. He says, do we have a yard? I said, there's a big yard, too. So I always remember those two questions he asked me. He was 6 years old.
And that was on Dawson Street?
Dawson, yeah. And then when he was 13, my dad passed away. Before he passed away, he told me that he has postal bonds. He said, it's enough for Andy to go to college. You know, I don't know how he knew when he was a young kid like that, but he could foresee it that, you know, some talent or something. And at that time, it was like $200 a semester. Now it's probably $30,000 or $40,000 a semester.
This is CMU?
Yeah, CMU.
Yeah.
And he did pass away like in 5 days. The only time you went to the hospital is when you're going to die. You know? That's what it seemed like. That's when people went to the hospital. So it was my responsibility. He told me to, you know, take care of Andy, make sure you don't lose the house from the taxes, because he paid cash for the house. It was $3,200, you know. That was, I guess, a lot of money then, you know. And I always admired my dad, because somebody to come in the country to know the language, save enough of money, you know, to buy a house. But the way he was able to save the money when he came to America, that First World War broke out, my mother couldn't come over, you know, so she was there for 8 years before, you know, until the war ended, the First World War. And then, you know, then she came over in 1921, they started the family then.
Oh, they came over from Slovakia?
Yeah, it was Austria-Hungary then, and then it was after the First World War, they changed it to Czechoslovakia. And every time there was a war, it was like Russia and other countries would take a piece of the land. And I was there about six times, but I could see why the farming, man, was just like a picture, you know. When you flew over, you could just see all, you know, all the fields, how nice and green, you know, the land was. And everybody wanted a piece of it. So then, when it was Czechoslovakia, the Slovaks wanted to have their own country, and the Czechs wanted their own. So they split it again. So it's like Slovakia and then...
Right, because we've been over there. We were in Bratislava.
Oh, were you?
Yeah.
Oh, it was pretty close. And,
Where were they from, what time?
Midtjylland bought it, so it was... nobody heard of it. That's where the music is.
Okay.
And when I was over, they wanted to build the museum. They should have went to Prague, but then those people told me if I put it in Prague, I said, I better not come over to visit them, because they said they won't treat you good, you know. But I think it should have been in a big city like Bratislava.
Well, that's certainly a nice city, especially the old section of the town.
Right, it's the gate.
Eventually they may move it, because I got them about 20 pictures, you know, from the museum. Then for the last 20 years I got them like 10,000 each year. That was a lot of money for them.
Wow.
Museum in Slovakia.
Right.
And then 2 years ago they invited me to Slovakia to honor me, and they took all kind of pictures.
And wow.
A couple, what would you call them? There's a picture of Slovakia, and it says that I'm a made citizen, you know, for all the work I did. So the one in English, I think, Marto. I have one that's a
Do they get a lot of visitors in that small town?
Well, they don't get as much. I mean, small countries all over, but it helps the young artists, you know. I still keep in contact with them. And I gave up the directorship. I gave it to my son, Don, you know. And when we were setting up the museum, I told him, but I'm a director, that's for life. And if any of my sons get on, I said, I want it, you know, written, you know, black and white, you know, and then have it in the bylaws like that. And then I was made vice president just by accident because, we, you know, those people who are setting the museum up, they didn't know anything about it. Like, they, the one they made is a secretary. And then Fred Hughes, he was... he was the president.
This is the foundation.
Yeah, we were start up after Andy died. So I told him, I said, I'm going to title too. So the attorney, he didn't know much. You know, I don't know enough about foundation. He said, we'll make you a vice president. So I'm still a vice president. You know.
Cool.
It just makes you feel good. Like, you know, it gives you some leeway. You know.
Well, and I think it's good because of, you know, the
family.
You're the family and you're being a part of it.
Were you involved in this one too, setting this one up?
Yeah, they wanted this in New York, and I used to go to meetings, and we had to, you know, have not arguments, but discussions. I told them there's enough museums in New York. I said, this should be, and I want to get it for Pittsburgh, you know. So I'm glad that they finally voted for Pittsburgh. They did some good things, they did some bad things, like, you know, they come across like they were new bills, $14,000, and we were at a meeting in New York before the museum started. They find that my mom was closed. I said, why don't you go to the family? And they says, no. They says, that should go to the museum here. And then the people from New York says, no, that should go to the foundation. So I didn't get anything of it. But I remember when I used to visit my mother, she used to tell me, you know, Andy used to give her like $100 bills for her birthdays. She used to save it and give it to the kids when they come up. And I remember before she got sick, she passed away, she told me that she has some money, it's in the clothes. You know, she's in her 70s, she couldn't remember exactly where it was. I remember, and I was, you know, looking for it, I couldn't find it. But then when they come across that money, you know, for meetings for the museum, and then they said they found $14,000 in her old clothes. Like, and I told them, I said, she'd go to the family.
Yeah, I would think that was an inheritance.
Those people don't think like me, you know.